First, I would like to bring up the first representative, or the first recipient, excuse me, Romona Robinson, anchor and journalist.
It means so much to me. If you could see my sleeve, I was trying to decide earlier if I was going to have the red sauce or the white sauce with the pasta. As you can probably see, I chose the white sauce because it's all over my sleeve. So I didn't want you to think I was a hog over the food. But I was talking to a Kent State student today by way of phone today, and she reminded me of something today when she thanked me for taking the time out of my busy schedule to give her some advice. She's a freshman at Kent right now, and she wants to become an anchor someday, and she reminded me of years ago when I started in the business, and I too sought the advice of another woman. I went over to our main anchor in Missouri and I lavished her with praise, and I told her what a great job she did. And I asked her if there was any advice she could give me. I was young, just starting out, nervous in the business. And she never even bothered to turn to look at me. And she said over her shoulder, "I think you do fine as you are." And that taught me such a valuable lesson that day. I vowed from that day forward, I would never treat another woman like that. And that's why I take the time with our children today. For 25 years now, I've been out canvassing Northeast Ohio, trying to spread inspiration and encouragement to our young kids, especially our inner city young females. They need that. And that's what I've been trying to do. I spend so much time, 2017 will be 20 years I've served as the honorary chair for the Susan G. Komen Race for the Cure. And every year I'm just amazed when I watch these women, the survivors, all the things that they've endured. They encourage me, they give me encouragement through their bravery. And so I know I'm on the right track with trying to work and give back. And lastly, I started in this business in 1988 here in Cleveland, Ohio, as the first black woman to anchor an evening newscast. And as I talked to the Kent State graduate this morning, she talked about being a child and watching me, and I had to quickly remind her, well, I've been in town 29 years, and since you're 19, you watch me since you were a child. But I was reminded of the hate that I suffered when I was announced as the first black woman to anchor an evening newscast. I faced so much. People think when you're the first, you get all of the accolades and people are congratulating you, but you don't get to see what's happening behind the scenes. And what was happening behind the scenes was a lot of pressure on me because I needed to prove that I was worthy of this job, even though I had the education, I had the experience. I had to prove that I was worthy. And I said, when I was interviewed by the Plain Dealer in 1988, my hope is that if I can succeed, that there would be other women and men of color to come up behind me. And as you look at television news in Cleveland, Ohio, you know that that's true today. And so I don't mind having to endure the pain, endure the hate, because 29 years later, those people who told me Cleveland didn't need a black woman, they had white, beautiful anchors. We don't need a black anchor. 29 years, I'm still here. I'm here to stay, and I just want you to know I will continue to work. on behalf of women because it's so important. Thank you.
When I was in grade 12, really little, I had just a little blanket on TV. And I remember the 10 o'clock news in the early 90s, another station we're at. She was the first news anchor that I saw on TV every night at 10 o'clock in the morning. I would watch that. And that is a true story. And to this day, I will always remember that. So you have inspired a lot of people, including myself. So give her a round of applause. Thank you.